Hi guys, I had a request from one of my subscribers on how she can embed an order form in a Flipbook, and that is why I'm doing this video. I did a video on how you can create a Flipbook, an online Flipbook, using Canva and Heyzine. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can embed an order form into this Flipbook. So we are going to be working with Canva, Heyzine, and of course, Google Forms. So let me show you the Flipbook we are going to be creating and the form and how the form is embedded in the Flipbook. Now, this is what we are going to be creating. This is the Flipbook we are going to create. And I'm going to show you the parts of the Flipbook at the end of the Flipbook where you can embed the order form. Now, this is it, where I said click to choose item and design that you want. So this is the form that is embedded in your Flipbook, where your customer, after seeing all your products, can always put in the kind of product they want, put in their name, their email address, whatever parameters you want. If you're conversant with using Google Forms, you know that you can put anything. You can even put your pictures and all that. Whatever you want. Multiple choices where somebody can just, you know, enter and submit. And if you look at this Flipbook, I do something like shop now, where I've also embedded a link to my shop so that if I click it, it takes it straight to my e-commerce store where I sell these print on demand t-shirts. So that is how wonderful it is, and this is exactly what I'm going to show you how to do. And this is so wonderful because you can embed it anywhere. You can put it in your website if you have a website, or you can just copy the link and share it anywhere in your social media if you do not have a website. So that is a good thing about it. Just put in the form, share it in social media, so whoever clicks, you know, submits this form, you will get it in your Google form, and then you're able to contact your customer and submit or send whatever it is, whatever item that your customer has chosen using this order form. So let's quickly go ahead and start. The very first thing you need to do is to go to Google, and we're going to create our Google form. So once you get to Google, you click on this spot here. As long as you have a Gmail account, you're going to see this. If you don't have a Gmail account, you can open a Gmail account. It's very easy to open. There are a lot of videos online that you can watch on how to open a Gmail account. So once you enter Google, go to this spot here, scroll down and get to Google Forms. So we are first going to create our forms that our customers can fill when they look at our Flipbook. I have forms that I've already created, but once you open get to here, you're going to have a choice of so many forms. You can choose any one from it, or you can just start afresh. But for me, it's always better to just choose something, you know, and just customize it. This other one is a t-shirt sign up. Let's look at this one. So what we'll do is to customize this form. As you can see, this is the form, this is what it looks like. And since we want to sell something, or we want our customers to choose something and write an email to us about what they want to buy. So for this particular form, I'm going to customize it. I will change this to something else. If you want to change it, it's very easy. Just do that and then write whatever you want to write and enter, and it stays. Then here, maybe the person's name. And if you want to duplicate this like this, I'll need to duplicate it to create a space for the email of the customer. So all you have to do is to click here to duplicate. So we'll change this one. Like now I can change this one now to email. So short answer, the person will put in the email there. Name required. So it's quite simple. If you want to add any other thing, just duplicate. Like I would like to add the customer should add maybe the customer, the product number. So I'll add another one. Just put item number. It's as simple as that. So let's go ahead and customize your form the way you want, depending on what you want your customers to fill out for you. Because it is this form now we are going to embed into our Flipbook. So this form now depends on what you want. So just customize it following the simple process I've just shown you. So I've customized my form. I've added an image. If you want to add an image, once you've created a section, just go here and you can add an image. It's as simple as that. Once you click here, it opens up to your computer and then you click the image that you want to upload. I've uploaded my image. I have added sections for name, for email, for address, for state, for country, for design number, for image number. And then for the color of the t-shirt that the person is interested in, after writing the image number. So once we are done with creating the form, our next stage is to get to Canva and create our PDFs that we are going to use to create the Flipbook. So I'm here in my Canva account. If you don't have a Canva account, it's also easy to sign up. Put your email and a password, you open a Canva account. Now, once you get to this page of your Canva, all you have to do is to put in a form. And then, A4 templates, just go to A4 templates. And then you can pick any one, let me just pick something, then customize this template. So all you have to do now is to put the pictures of all the products that you want to sell to your customers. As simple as that. And you know, if you're not used to Canva, I have a video that I'll link right here on how you can use Canva. It's intuitive, it's easy to use, you get used to it, that you continue to use it. So all you have to do is to add all your pages that you want, add all your pictures that you want to sell. Of course, you must have had your pictures in your Canva. If you don't know how to upload your pictures to Canva, it's very easy. Once you go to uploads right here, go to upload files, and once you click on upload files, it opens up your computer, and then you can upload all the pictures of your products that you already have on your computer onto Canva. So that is what I did, and I uploaded all the pictures of my print-on-demand t-shirts that I want to sell. So I'm going to put all the pictures here, and then we go on from there. I've uploaded all the pictures I want. I've created my first page, speaking tees. This is what I want to sell. These are my designs that I can put on objects, t-shirts, hoodies, and so on. These are my designs, and I've given my designs numbers so that when the person is filling the form, the person will fill the particular design the person wants, and of course the kind of t-shirt the person wants. And I've done some mock-ups to show how those designs look on these t-shirts and all that. If the person wants a hoodie, I've given it a number, so the person can just write the number, write the color of the hoodie. Once I see this number, I know it's for this kind of hoodie, and then the person can choose the color depending on the form that we just created in Google Forms. So once you do this, what you need to do at the end of all your entries, keep an open, clear one that we're actually going to use to put our forms. You can decide to write something on it or just leave, but let there be a clear page. Then of course I have this page where I added shop now, and I added a link here. To add a link here is quite easy. Once you click on it, you go to let me see. Oh, it's not position. Right here. So you can click here. Once you click there, you can put the link. Like now I put the link of my shop here. So the link is there, done. So this is now ready for the next stage. Now you're going to go to Google once again, and you're going to go put in Heyzine PDF to Flipbook, and then you're going to sign up. I already have an account, that is why I can go to my dashboard, but you sign up. To sign up, it's just an email and a password. And then a link will be sent to that your functioning email, and then you click the link and it takes you to this page. So you've signed up for Heyzine. Once you've done that, we now go back to our PDF products that we have created. This is what we have created. And then you go to share. Once you go to share, you go to more. And when you get to more, just put in Heyzine. But once you put HE, it comes out right here. You click on it. And then remember the pages. I have 25 pages, so it will be 1 to 25. Always remember that, to put the number of pages you have, 1 to 25. Then click on done, click on save. And then it's going to prepare your designs. It takes a few seconds to prepare your designs. Once that is done, just view on Heyzine. So the flipbook is being processed. So you wait for your flipbook to be processed. It's just as simple as that. Few more minutes for it to be processed. And that is the flipbook. That is as easy as that. That is our flipbook. So now, how do we incorporate our form into this lovely flipbook? Remember, this is our page. And we want to put our form. So what you will do, you scroll down right here and go to web. Click and drag to select the area in a page. Then click stop editing on the side menu to go back to preview mode. During edit mode, some flipbook effects are disabled. So what you will do now, this is where I want to put the form. So I will just click here to put the form. And then I am going to go back to my Google form, Google Sheet. This is my Google Sheet that we prepared. And then I'm going to go to send, and I'm going to click this web, HTML, and then I'm going to copy it. So once I've copied, I'll come back to my Heyzine, and I'm going to paste it right there. And I'm going to click on apply, and then I'm going to click on close. That is the form. That is the form. Okay. So once you do that, you need to go back and click on stop editing. That is the form. So whenever anybody comes here, the person will be able to just scroll and fill in their details inside the form, and after they have filled in their details, they will just click on submit, and then you'll see the person will do everything, and then the thing will come back to your Google form where you will find the what has already been filled. So once you're done, remember to save it, and then you can share it anywhere on your social network or wherever you want to share the link for people that where you know your customers are. So you can share it in the web. If you have a website, you can share it in your social networks. You can download it. And so this here is the link. You can click here to copy the link and then share it to all the places that you want to share it. So it's as easy as that, quite easy. So go ahead and create your flipbook, share your products, whatever your products is that you want to share, because it makes it very nice and very, very interactive, very nice. So go ahead and do that. Then drop your comments below. If you had any difficulty anywhere, drop your comments below. Thank you so much for watching, for with this I've come to the end of this video. And if you enjoyed it, remember to subscribe for other digital tips.